What is up, YouTube? Thrift School over here, sitting out front of the library. I'm gonna head in there and we're gonna buy lots of stuff. I'm actually mostly looking for CDs. This place has CDs, DVDs, video games, books, toys. I buy a lot of it and I'm gonna film downstairs and you guys are gonna see it all. I believe it's all in the basement of this place, so I'll be right under there. All right, just got my number. I was 12th in line right over here. Everybody's coming out to wait because we still got an hour before the sale starts. So I'm just gonna chill in the car and eat my trail mix. Let's do it. All right, it's 15 minutes until the sale starts. I got my reusable bags. Now, supposedly this sale is all the leftovers from last sale that they had in the winter. So who knows if it's actually gonna be any good. It might really suck. So I'm gonna try and film down there. You never know what we'll find. Let's see.
There are areas that are marked off. They are blocked. Please do not climb over or around any of the barriers. The books that are on those shelves are not for sale today. All along the whole path are books. Somewhere right around where the... We all ready?
Oh, no, is it there?
All right. Very cool.
Very good.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm trying to find CDs, DVDs, video games. Let's see. There's all the CDs. I'm gonna get to scanning. It's all VHS. Pretty cool, let's start scanning. So here's the sale. It's looking pretty packed right now. I've been scanning CDs for a while, and you know what? Just gotta keep going. Haven't found too many, but I'm scanning as many as I can. I'm hooked up to the Wi-Fi. Always get that Wi-Fi password before you go into the basement. Alright guys, bonus content at Goodwill. I'm going to show you everything I picked up at that book sale as well very shortly when we get home. But let's run inside here. I was dropping some eBay packages off, which you guys can see on the screen right here. I sold a disc-only CD. Now that's what I call music. Didn't make a lot of money on that. Made practically nothing. Well, I didn't make practically nothing. I only shipped it off for 70 cents, so I think I made about $3 on it, which, that's alright. I got a lot of them. I sold two DVD sets for 14 bucks a piece to the same person, so they shipped via media mail and only cost me about $3.27 to ship, so not bad there. Made some good money on those. Paid less than 50 cents each, about a quarter each, in a big DVD lot that I got those in. And I sold a Salvatore Ferragamo tie, as you guys can see. And this tie sold for $20. I took a best offer. Salvatore Ferragamo has gone down a lot recently, guys. I used to be able to sell used Salvatore Ferragamo ties for $25, $35, $45 all day, and now I see them sell brand new for 30 bucks on eBay. So the market is flooded, the prices are tanking. Be careful with spending a lot of money on those ties, but let's head inside the Goodwill right now and make some money. Here we are inside of the Goodwill, and I'm taking a look at the video games mixed in with the DVDs. I found a Left 4 Dead 2 complete. Hey, I love that. $3 on that. Not bad. I'm gonna double my money. I'm okay with that. I also found a calculator and a Polaroid. I ended up putting back the Polaroid because the sell-through just wasn't that good. It just isn't really worth it. And the calculator didn't have a price. They had to do a whole price check thing, so I also had to leave that behind due to it not having a sticker on it. I hate when that happens, and it kind of happens a lot. I wanted to take a look on the other side, and I see some more games. This game has been here for about a week, as Sonic and Sega the Rings, and look at that. It's not there anymore. Somebody stole it. Why are you stealing a $2 game? I decided to check this Modern Warfare 3 and it's still in there because it's brand new. I do notice that. If a game sits for about a week or so, a lot of times it's not in the case. Kids come in, people come in, and they just steal the games. I don't know why. It just happens. But the newer ones that come out, never stolen. They're always sitting there.
I then found this cool Evil Dead 2 toy for $4. I'm not sure if it was a toy or some type of art, brand new sealed, but when I saw Loot Crate on it, I got a little nervous because Loot Crate stuff usually doesn't sell for a lot. A lot of people just buy them and resell them if they don't get what they want in their little Loot Crate that comes every month, and this one wasn't worth anything. You guys can see on eBay, it's only selling for about 11 bucks free shipping. There was no money there to be made, but I did find a cool little game right here that I'm going to be able to sell for some money. I think it's time to go. Let's head home and see what we found.
Okay guys, we are back in the garage. I have everything behind me that I want to show you guys that I picked up from Goodwill and that book sale. Now, I have a totally different method for sourcing at book sales. I go for the CDs, look at the DVD box sets, if they have toys or random things. I don't really scan for the books because, as you guys saw, there's could be 100, 200 people there waiting in line and they're all going for the books. So I like to go for the things that most people aren't going for. And I'm just able to find more that way. Now, it was the half off day, so not so great. For them, half off day is just the remnants. Everything's already been picked through at the last sale. So this is stuff that, you know, had already been completely sorted through, but I still found some good things. I only bought, about 30, a little less, I think 22 CDs and one book. And at Goodwill, I got a few things that you guys didn't see on camera. So let's take a look now. All right, so this little pile of stuff that I need to organize is actually getting bigger, which isn't good. So I am going to be going through all of this today, but I want to show you guys what I ended up picking up. First things first, oh no, that's stuff from a car. Let me get rid of that. First things first is the book sale. We got a bunch of things in here. You can see the stacks of CDs looking beautiful. And this guy actually goes for a lot of money, but the rank is really high, so I think it's inflated. I picked it up. All of these are only a dollar each, so I did pick up some things that I'm going to experiment with and hope that it sells for good money. Who knows if it'll sell? It might never do. It might never sell, but oh my gosh, guys, my words are all over the place. It might never sell, so who knows? Real quick, I want to correct myself on this CD. I scanned it so I could get a screenshot for you guys while I was editing, and I don't know what happened, but the first time I scanned it at the sale, a different listing came up that showed it a very high rank selling for around $50. But each time I scan it now, it's showing up still a very high rank, but it's only going for about a dollar after fees. So yeah, that's not going to be any money there. But the rest of these hopefully are good. I don't know. Always double check, I guess. I did scan it. There was nothing else I could have scanned. That was the only barcode. And for some reason, it came up with the wrong listing. Amazon, thank you very much. So yeah, not going to be worth as much as I thought. But hopefully it does. We got a whole bunch of CDs in here. Now, of course, I'm always looking for brand new sealed things like this. You know, mainstream kind of band, Macklemore, Ryan Lewis, kind of a newer CD. So it's not going to go for a lot of money, but I only paid a dollar, and it's going to sell for, you know, I think $11, something like that. You guys see it right over here on the screen, so hopefully I do get some good money for it. I think it will because it has a great rank. And some extra CDs right here. Some are new, some are used, so I won't bore you guys by going through all of them. But one thing I got that was completely different, nobody was looking through them, were the music sheets. And I found this Gershwin at the Keyboard. Now, I had a whole bunch of different music sheet books in this bag right here. But once I opened them up, there was pencil writing all over on the inside. So it was a good thing I opened them up. I almost bought like six of these. And I just had to put them all back because they were filled with pencil writing. So I kept this one. I could ship it right off to Amazon. It's got a barcode right there, and it was originally selling for $10.95. Paid $1 for this as well. I thought I was going to be paying 50 cents for it, but they charged me a dollar. So it's okay. It's still not bad. Here's the receipt. What did I spend? $23 in cash. Really, I thought I was going to be spending a lot more than that. I thought I was going to be getting a lot more than that, but still not bad. I'm happy with that score. Now on to Goodwill. Just got this. This isn't the bag from Goodwill. Where's the Goodwill bag? It's over here somewhere, guys. Oh, it's over here. So I picked up a couple things that you guys didn't see, or at least one thing you guys didn't see. Hopefully it works. We got a PlayStation 2 Slim for $20, and it came with all the cords and the controller. So if it works, this is a pretty sweet score. 20 bucks is about the max that I like to pay for these.
They sell for a decent amount on Amazon, the slim versions. The fat ones, they don't sell for as much. So I always keep an eye out for these really little skinny PlayStation 2s. I also picked up that Left 4 Dead 2 game, $3. Not bad there. And this little card game, a Whatchamma Draw at $3. So, you know, I didn't spend too much. Here's my receipt again. I spent $24.70, I think it is. So I didn't spend too much money, but hey, I'm still happy to hopefully make some good money here. I mean, all of this stuff, they are going to sell. Great sales rank, pretty good sales rank, but this game sells very easily. And these sell pretty quick if it works. So hopefully it works. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. I did get some cool things. You know, all this from Goodwill, all of that from the book sale. I'm going to be going to another book sale soon, guys. There's a bunch going on around Connecticut, so I'm going to keep my eye out. We're going to get more CDs. I'm going to hopefully film inside them a little bit more and maybe some more music sheets. Who knows? If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up. Comment down below if you have any questions. Subscribe if you haven't already. This is Thrift School signing out. See ya.